Hi Ram, it's a great privilege offered to me, Sai Ram, and just in the very initial stage, in the beginning itself, let me tell you all that I am not at all an orator. I have not been giving big speeches. So, as I recollect one incident that happened, when Swami was asking one of his students to come and deliver a speech, and this boy was nervous. He was also a bit reluctant to do it. So it could be once or twice or thrice Swami prompted him to speak. He did not budge. Then Swami came to him and told, "Do you see that mic?" Then Swami asked him, he showed him the mic and it was singing a song and some bhajan is going on from inside the mandir. And he said, "Yes, Swami, that's a mic and it is singing, it is just giving out the output of a song." He told, "Where is the song coming from?" So this boy, little boy, he said that somebody is singing from inside. The bhajan is going on inside the mandir. Then Swami asked, "Who is singing? The mic is singing?" "No, Swami, it is somebody inside." So that's where you are. When you start, it is going to be me who is going to prompt everything that comes out from your mouth. So you are like a mic. And what you're going to speak out is going to be what Swami wants to deliver you through you. So I feel that the same situation is right now with me. I beg Swami to guide me to deliver this small rendering so that you all can enjoy and experience what had passed through my life of this 60 years of my existence. Sai Ram. Tvameva matascha pita tvameva tvameva bandhuscha sakha tvameva tvameva vidya dravinam tvameva tvameva sarvam mama deva deva tvameva sarvam mama deva deva tvameva sarvam mama deva deva Sri Sai Deva. Swami, you are my everything. Can I have the first slide? So, just I wish to put that he is everything. Coming by the way, he is our mother, he is our father, and he is the bandhu, sakha, everything. Swami, let's be guided by you with your pure love and blessings. So to start with my own experiences with Swami, I would like to put that those early days when I was a child, budding elementary school student, I had not known Swami at all. I hailed from a very small village in Tamil Nadu. It's called Thiruvayyaru. But of course, it's very famous for its religious background. Like we had the saint Tyagaraja, who was a great composer, who sang so many kritis on Lord Rama. So he hailed from there and his samadhi is there. Then we have a very big Shiva temple. So I came from that small village. I knew of all the small scriptures that as a young boy should know, which was taught to me by my parents and by my gurus. But Swami was not known to me and neither to my family as well. So the days passed by, I had to shift all the way to West Bengal due to some family needs. My father was working in West Bengal in a town called Kharagpur. So that's where I just neared my matriculation. And during such period, my Kaki, that is my father's elder brother's wife, she was a Balavikas guru. So she was just getting into her fold as a Balavika student and I just attended all the classes now and then, just out of sheer interest. And could be those days is such an adolescent period. We just knew that singing and reciting slokas, these were all we were doing playfully. But these were all getting implanted in me, just like a nail goes into a, what you say, in a small, this what you say, in a tree. So things were going on like that. Even now, Swami was just a person on a calendar or something like that. I never knew, I never heard, I never seen Swami directly or physically. So now the time had come. When I finished my 10th standard and my father was looking to admit me somewhere in Tamil Nadu for my higher college education, as he felt that that would be better. Then he took me to Tamil Nadu. Everywhere I was seeking admission, but due to some academic inequalities, I was not offered a seat in any of the colleges. There was some bit of, though I was a good student, I didn't do any bad in the academics. So that's how the days passed and I was not getting a seat anywhere. This is, of course, looks like something Swami had already designed where I had to stay. Then my father said, come on, let's get back to West Bengal and you will continue your studies in Kharagpur. Fine, we returned back to Chennai and we had to take a train back to Calcutta. So that's how I was going to start. Then at Chennai, I got the information that I received a call letter from Sri Satya Sai College, Whitefield, Bangalore. My father said, Bangalore? We have never been there. We don't know that place. It's totally new for us. No, son, we'll not go there. And we set back, we went to West Bengal back to continue my education there in the school. Then it was time when I had to go, reluctantly join the school. Actually, I had planned to go back to South. But now the education was destined that I have to study here only. Of course, I'm going to be with my parents. So when I wanted to join the school, I was struck with a very bad disease. I wouldn't say disease, sickness. I was affected with dysentery. It was continuous. I'm losing all my strength in my body. All the fluid is losing. And I have become so weak. I was unable to go to school and also unable to get up and stand on my feet. Leave aside thinking of going to school. So this is the condition when suddenly a second letter arrives from Satya Sai College, Whitefield, asking me to avail the second chance of joining the college, failing to which the seat will be offered to some other student. So now is the time something stirred in me. Some feeling said, come on, this is not the place where you have to stay. You have to go. Somebody is calling. You are destined to go to a place where you have to spend rest of your life with his thought. So Swami has called me. So now I prepared mentally. I told my father that, Appa, I cannot stay in this place. I want to join that college. Father said, it is Bangalore. Another 2 days of journey all the way back to Chennai and then to Bangalore. And just in such a short notice that we have just come from there and again you have to go back. I don't know how I can make it. And you are in a very bad health. You are unable to even stand on your leg. So then it happened. So my Kaki, who was my Balvikas guru, she came to know that I had received the call and this was the second letter that I received. Believe me, I did not apply for this college. This college application was put by my Kaki. And when she came to know that I had already ignored the first letter and this is the second letter which has come, she just jumped on me and my father. She said, hurry, Swami will take care of everything. You just pack up and take Swaminathan to Bangalore and admit him in the Satya Sai College. Then the local samiti, we had one Mr. Mukherjee as a convener. he also intervened. He said that it's a great chance, and there are boys standing in queue to admit their children there. The students are waiting to get a chance. While your son has got such a noble offer, he is getting the second time offer to come. Then my father felt that yes, everybody is persuading him. Why not he start making the arrangement? Imagine, same day he applied for the leave. Same day, he is a railway employee. He applied for a railway pass, and there you have the accommodation in the train. There are a vacancy of 2 berths by which I can travel for the 2 nights back to Chennai and Bangalore. Oh God, this is a miracle actually. Then Mr. Mukherjee, he sent a few packets of Swami's Vibhuti. He said that just take this as a medicine. That will take care of your health and you will surely improve. So that night I am to board the Madras Mail, and then my brother, in my very feeble condition, he put me on the cycle and he took me all the way to the station, literally carrying me and putting into the train. Now, the train journey started the first day, the first night over, and the second night finished fast off, and the morning we arrived at Chennai, I was perfectly fine. The medicine has worked. The Vibhuti has created a miracle and a magic in me. My complete dysentery was over. I am looking fresh. What has made all this fine? Now, even now, I don't know who is Swami. I am going to join his college. Now, we went to Bangalore. We had not known anybody, as I told even before. Father was reluctant to put me in Whitefield just because he had never been to Bangalore. He don't know the place. Now, in Bangalore, we had a contact. Somebody had told, please go to him. He will take care of everything. Then we went to his house. And that gentleman, much more than the closest relative that can offer, he had offered me all the host, what as a host, what he needs to do to me. I had a very good accommodation to stay along with him. And then he guided how to go to Whitefield. Then there, my father took me to Whitefield. Now, this is the first time I am entering the portals of Swami's ashram. Something divine, it just overtook me. My feelings were all surging. I am entering into the ashram and into the college. Next slide, please. So now you can see the hostel from the far end of the ashram gate. So it's a beautiful building which was built by one devotee called Walter Cogan. So this building was also having its own story behind it. Walter Cogan was a devotee from abroad, and he lost his life. He died. And then Swami had resurrected him. So this miracle had happened much, I can't exactly remember the year. So this devotee, in the fond memory of his resurrection, of his rebirth, he had offered to build this beautiful hostel. Okay, fine. I had just entered the hostel, and now still I have not seen Swami. My father had not seen. And I was imagining Swami to be a very, very rough character, could be very strict, very disciplined, a disciplinarian, could be punishing everybody. All such thoughts were going on. And now, as I got into the hostel, and there appeared Swami with his red robe flowing on the ground, and he was coming towards the this devotee's shed over there. We have a beautiful shed those days, now which is turned into a big Sai Ramesh hall. Now that shed had a Krishna idol. This I'm talking about Whitefield, that is in Bangalore. So this beautiful Krishna statue, the devotees sit all around it and sing the bhajans. So Swami comes and gives darshan to all the devotees over there and gets back to the ashram, and the students had the unique privilege to be going inside the ashram. So now again here there is another story. Before this hostel built, the plan was totally different actually. And in 1975, that's when the hostel came into existence. That's when the hostel was built. Swami had initially planned that the place where the hostel is now, the college will be built. So the drawing was all made, approved, and the architects were working on getting the college ready over there. In the meantime, the hostel is planned in the place where right now the college is. That is about 1 furlong away. So the students were totally upset because now they lived very near to Swami, just in one shed, which is the present Kalyana Mantap. If you see, the hostel is there, and next to the hostel is the ashram. So in between, you can see those trees. There is a Kalyana Mantap, and that was the residential accommodation for the boys. And those days in 1977, when I joined, there were only about 25 boys. Then these boys had to go all the way to the hostel, which is furlong, 1 furlong or even about 2.5 kilometer away. They were feeling very, very sad. Oh, Swami, you are keeping us so near to you. Now you are pushing us away so far. And they were all very remorse and sad. Then one day when Swami saw, read their face, he asked one small boy, "What happened? Why are you so sad?" Then Swami said, "Swami, can't you have the hostel built here instead of the college? We don't want to leave you and go so far away." Then Swami, see the pure love that he has on these boys. On the spot, he called the architect, "Come on, change the drawing, get the hostel built here, and have the college being built a furlong or 2 furlong away, which is right now existing over there." So this is how the hostel came about. Now, when I joined, we were about 200 students, and I had my first entry into the hostel. Next slide, please. The Lord Saraswati, the goddess of learning, she has blessed all the 200 boys that were living inside in that portal. And after all, who is there to guide us? Who is the warden? It is he himself, Swami. Swami himself was the warden for us. He is going to take care of us. So the routine of the hostel used to be like this. We used to get up early hours. We used to have the morning Omkar 21 times and then the Shuprabhatam. And that is how the day began every day for us. And then we started with our morning exercises, and some did yoga, some used to go and for jogging. And in the around morning 8:30 or so, just before the college began, we had to have our breakfast, and we had to rush to the ashram to have Swami's darshan. Because if Swami is there in Vrindavan, now let me tell you, these were the days. That is between 77 when I joined and I left Baba's ashram in Bangalore in 84. That is 7 years. The stay of Swami was mostly in Vrindavan. He was almost 9 months in Vrindavan, and he used to go only for 3 months to Parthi. So you can believe, just like Dwapara Yuga, where Lord Krishna in his younger days, as a child and up to his as a young boy, as a cowherd boy, he lived with the gopis in Vrindavan. So I just, I feel that the same thing can be correlated here. Like, we were like gopis, and we enjoyed the complete physical form of Swami with us. And almost every day, morning and evening, we used to get Swami's darshan. And Swami, in just even without fail, he used to come to the hostel every Thursdays and Sundays. And Thursdays and Sundays, not just come and go, he used to give a long lecture of 1 hour on so many various topics. So life was totally filled with all the joy that we had. See, we were not only learning the academic education, we were also being fed with all the spiritual and all the adhyatmic and all the spiritual knowledge that need to be gained through Swami himself. And add on to it, during the summer of 77 and 78, even I attended the summer course. The summer course used to be a 1 month festival wherein all the students And even many delegates from different parts of the country used to come to the college. We had a very beautiful auditorium. And Swami himself used to give on selected topics on every evening. He used to deliver the this lecture, Bhashya. So one of the summer course, I heard Swami delivering Bhagavad Gita for 30 days. And another summer course in the next year, in the 78, I believe, it was on Mahabharata. So Swami giving complete 30 days of lecture on these two epics. So it is so elevating, and at such a tender age, when you hear such a noble literatures being put into your head, it just gets into it. You know, it gets into the head. You just can't forget such learnings. So this is how we passed our first few years. And believe me, each and every time Swami used to see us, Swami used to tell that don't get carried away, that Swami is very near you and this is not going to be forever. You will see that Swami is distancing from you. Slowly, slowly, you will be not having the same privileges like this, what you are enjoying now. So these things, true to these Swami's words, we could see that as I proceeded from the 77 till then to the 1984, that the visits of Swami to the hostel had totally stopped. And Swami then later started going more towards Puttaparthi, because Puttaparthi was emerging as a big hub. There was a big university coming up, Swami Satya Sai Institute of Higher Learning. It started coming up as 108th university of the country. So Swami was more busy and he was going more towards Parthi. So this we can correlate that as a Krishna moved to Dwaraka as a king of the Yadavas. So slowly and steadily, we see that the Swami's visits and all this is diminishing in Puttaparthi, from Vrindavan, and Swami moving all the way to Puttaparthi. Now, coming again to back to the hostel life, we could feel that Swami's presence so much that we were so complacent, like, Swami, oh, he is with us. He will always be with us. So like that, the feeling used to be going inside every student's mind. And Swami used time and again, he used to, in his own loving way, he used to correct us. He used to say, boys, take it from me that, can I have the next slide? Okay, so these are the hostel. Next one. Yeah, in the hostel, I would say that when I entered into the hostel, I was expecting a sort of a double room or something where two cots will be there and we will all have a very deluxe life. But it is not so. The Satya Sai hostel is totally different. We had about 10 desks wherein a chair and a foldable desk was available there, and we had to keep all our luggage just below the desk and on a cupboard just above the desk. And our sleeping, we need to have a small bed which we had brought from home. We had to sleep in the small space that was provided. So there were about 10 students in a room. Initially, it was very hurting. We thought that, what life is this? So 10 people in a room. But you see, that is how Swami taught brotherhood. And we were made to feel that the 10 is nothing but it is one. All 10 are just one. And all the rooms ultimately leads to one same Atma, which leads our life attached to the only one Paramatma, who is Swami. So the life was going on like this, and we had all the duties which needed to be done by ourselves. Like, for example, cutting the vegetables, rolling chapati, which probably in my home I never had done before. But now it was to be done by all the students themselves. We had all the room duties allotted. This week it will be vegetable cutting, and this week, next week, it will be chapati rolling. And another week it could be serving. in the dining hall. So life went on with all such discipline, and discipline was never forced. It was coming all by automatically, by Swami teaching us and Swami just feeling us experience it, how the silence helps you to feel the inner self. So going by this way, there were turbulent days, and I would like to mention, I will just come to it a bit later. Can you go ahead with the slide? Yeah, these are all Swami, out of his love. He used to call us and give us the group photo. Like we used to, this is my second year of pre-university. Please go ahead. Yeah, this is my final year degree. So these are all real blessed time that we had. Swami was indeed, we could never feel that he was God. And we could feel that a guru, a loving guru, who is just near to us, always will be always near to us. So this is the thought which we are all growing there. So one of the occasion in which Swami came to the hostel and he was delivering a lecture on Janmashtami day. And on this day, what happened, Swami came to the hostel and he asked to close all the doors, the dining hall doors. And then Swami started his lecture on Janmashtami and speaking about the life story of Lord Krishna. He was telling that Krishna, as you perceive today, he is not very fair looking, or that he was very dark and he was not wearing all jewels and all that. He was like a simpleton, and as a cowherd, he used to wear a cloth on his head like this. So Swami himself pulled up a cloth nearby and he just tied it like a rope. You can see it on that slide. And Swami explained about Krishna and all the gopis, how the life went on in Dwapara Yuga. Then he created, that day he created one Kaustubhahara, which Krishna had a story behind that. This Kaustubhahara got lost and Krishna was blamed for having stolen. Then after that it is retrieved. And Swami just created that Kaustubhahara and he showed us, and then he put it near that Krishna idol which is on the side. So this was a very great experience we had. Swami had completely transformed us to the Dwapara Yuga, literally. I could feel that. Okay, Sairam, then let me tell you the turbulent days that we had. These days, we actually, Swami used to keep telling us, you boys are all talking too much. I'm not liking it. You have to correct yourself. Talk less and think more about Swami. But you do the other way. You are talking too much. So it went on, the warning went on once, warning went on twice. And the third time, it is no more warning, Swami himself is not there. Swami left without any announcement. He had moved off to Puttaparthi. It was in some early hours, which the boys were all, half of them were asleep. And they came to know through some boys who had kept track of all this. And they said, Swami gone. Swami is angry on us. He is not liking the way we are behaving in the hostel. So now, this is the time, is a very turbulent time which boys had to face. They are all literally very, very sad. Because, see, the Swami who stays for 9 months, and if he suddenly goes away, it hurts a lot. We had to literally cry. And the emotions used to surge through the bhajans, actually. Our evening bhajans in the hostel used to be very, very remorseful and very, very sad. So many songs used to pour out from the heart. So I just would like to share with you one of the songs. Tu hai anath bando karuna sindhu he sai bhagwa sukh dukh aur dard ko दूर करो सुख के कारण दुख के निवारण। मैं क्या जानू तेरी महिमा, मैं क्या जानू तेरी महिमा। माया ममता में सब है अंधेरा, माया ममता में सब है अंधेरा। तू है अनंत बंगो। साईराम, जस्ट लेट मी हैव द नेक्स्ट स्लाइड। सो यू सी द ब्यूटीफुल मीनिंग ऑफ द सॉन्ग। You are the guardian of this orphan. Tu hai anath bandhu. O Sai Bhagwan, merciful Lord, dukh aur dard ko dur karo. Please eliminate our sadness and pain. Sukh ke karan dukh ke nivaran. Joy can be obtained only by removing the sadness. Then, main kya jaanu teri mahima. Oh Lord, what do I know about your greatness? I am such a small being. Your greatness is boundless. Maya mamata me sab hai andhera. The illusion and the complacency has blinded us. We never realized that you are the ultimate. We were just thinking you are so close and we committed this blunder. So Swami, please forgive us, forgive us. So this is one song, and another song which literally brings tears into me. Anath bandho Sai Prabhu, apraadh shama karo Sai Prabhu, jeev yatra mein saath raho. जीव यात्र में साथ रहो, प्रेम भक्ति हमको दीजो, हृदय मंदिर से मत जाओ, साईं हृदय मंदिर से मत जाओ, चरणामृत सेवा दीजो प्रभु, चरणामृत सेवा दीजो प्रभु। सो साईराम, आफ्टर सच पेनफुल भजन्स, सडनली द लाइट्स ऑन द भजन रूम इज पुट ऑन, एंड देन द वार्डन कम्स इन एंड ही रीड्स अ लेटर। यू नो व्हाट द लेटर कंटेन्स? स्वामी हैज हर्ड अस। He says that, boys, Swami has pardoned you. Swami is coming to Vrindavan tomorrow. So, God, we are on the other side of the tunnel. We had all the way put our pains, and all this did not go in vain. Swami has blessed us. Swami has pardoned us. He is coming back. So, the next day, Swami comes. So, this is the Diwali that we have. What better day can that be than having our Swami back? Sairam. Let me go to the next slide. So this how the days rolled by, and then I was never a singer. I was going to the bhajan in the Swami's ashram, because other days in the evening, other than the days on which Swami used to come to the hostel, the other days used to be inside the ashram. Swami had a small hall which is about 50 feet long and about 10 feet in width. So nearly about 30-40 boys can sit inside. So literally you have to queue up. If you are an early bird, you get a seat in front of Swami. Swami will come and sit in the middle. All the boys sit around him. And I used to be definitely an early bird almost every time. So I used to feel so jealous of those bhajan singers. You know, they used to get the front seat without much competition. They get to sit just next to Swami, all around Swami. Now this earnest feeling came in me. Why can't I sing? I can sing. While they have the chance, why not me? Swami, I am same to you as they are. So I just mustered all my courage. I put a small note on a small piece of paper and I rolled it. I went on the first day. I took as close as possible to Swami, just behind the singers. And then the bhajans went on, went on, went on. Swami is pointing each and every boy, you sing, you sing, you sing. And they are regular singers, huh? Not others, only the regular singers. Then I'm looking with so much of, craving that I have to sing also. And this small bit of paper which is telling Swami, Swami, please allow me to sing in your physical presence. Because if I just write in front of you, then he might say you can sing anywhere. So I wanted to put it very specific. I want to sing in front of your physical form. Then I rolled it. There is no courage to give it to Swami. One day, 2 days, then the third day, no, it's enough. If I wait more longer, it's never going to happen. I held my hand out to Swami. Swami with fiery eyes, you know, his eyes are like just fire, you know, when he looks into you. Then he saw me. He saw my hand held with a small chit of paper, rolled. He took it. Oh, there my breath, I am grasping for breath. I don't know what's going to happen. Then Swami, bhajan is going on, somebody is singing. Then he opens the paper. Then he tears it into so many pieces. He tore the paper. And he tore the paper and just put it behind a chair. Then I thought that's the end of the day, end of my last day in the hostel. Maybe after the bhajan, I'll be instructed to leave the hostel. Swami would tell the warden to send this boy out. Then what happened? The last singer had sung. Then Swami looks at me. Ah, Padu. He asked me to sing. Oh my God, what's happening? Swami is asking me to sing. I am literally not prepared because all the fear and aspiration that I will be punished, everything is running in me. Where can I sing? Then Swami says, yeah, sing. I closed my eyes. I just came out with some bhajan, which came out automatically from me. It's nothing planned before. The song came out from me automatically. It came from my heart. So I sang it with all my devotion, all my feelings. I imagined that I'm totally in Vrindavan. I'm singing in front of my Lord as a Krishna. So the song finished. Then Swami was swaying to the song. He was beating that taal, you know. And then the day finished. And the next day, again, the bhajan session came. I again gained the reputation as a registered singer. Swami said, come. Swami said, after everybody sang, Swami said, you sing the same song. Same song as yesterday. Then I sang the same song. The third day came, same song. Swami is prompting me, Balram ki bhaiya. Then I sang the same song. Even to the extent the warden told, hey, come on, every day you are singing the same song. What happened? Why don't you change? Then I told, Swami is asking, what can I do? So, this went on like that, and that is my first beautiful experience that Swami had given me a chance to sing. I want to share with you all this also. Madhuvan ki mohana murali bajaiya Giridhari Shyam Manaiya, Giridhari Nanda Kumar Kanaiya, Madhubani ki Mohan Murali Bajaiya, Giridhari Nanda Kumar Kanaiya, Ananda Ram Bala Ram Ji ke Bhaiya, Anand naam Balaram ji ke bhaiya, गिरिधारी नंदन कुमार कन्हैया, गिरिधारी नंद कुमार कन्हैया, गोपी मनोहर रास रचैया, गिरिधारी नंद कुमार कन्हैया, गिरिधारी नंद कुमार कन्हैया, गिरिधारी नंद कुमार कन्हैया। तो साई राम, सो दिस वॉज अ लाइफ ऑफ लाइफ टाइम अचीवमेंट फॉर मी, नथिंग एल्स इन माई लाइफ। देन द डेज पास्ड ऑन, इट वॉज माई फाइनल ईयर, आई हैड टू लीव द कॉलेज। देन वी वर गिवन एन इंटरव्यू फॉर ऑल द फाइनल ईयर स्टूडेंट्स। देन स्वामी केम नियर मी, आई जस्ट कॉट होल्ड ऑफ हिज लेग्स। आई टोल्ड स्वामी, हाउ वुड आई गो आउटसाइड वर्ल्ड ऑल दीज ईयर्स, आई वॉज विथ यू एंड आई एम टोटली लॉस्ट इन दिस न्यू वर्ल्ड, आई के नॉट नाउ फेस द आउटसाइड वर्ल्ड। Then happened so that Swami cajoled my hair. He told, Bangaru, you cannot always be here. The river has to flow. You have to give place for the new boys to come. So go and be like a street light. Give the light to all the passers-by below you. So this is what happened. I had to leave with such a heavy heart and my 33 years of my stay, leaving Swami, went with a profession as I was in my oil field profession. I was in different places in country. Then I went to Gulf countries, so many places. Believe me, Swami's teaching and Swami's way of behaving with people and Swami, what he taught, all these things were imbibed in me and it was carried on. I never had anybody as an enemy in my life. Everybody liked, not because I was a Swami student, but the attitude and the love which he had taught me. Okay, so this is how the 33 years went passed by. Then I had retired. Now I'm 61. I came back to my Salem, this hometown, and I thought it's going to be a sort of a lone, isolated life. But here is Swami again. He just picked me up. Pulled me up. Come on, that's not time for you to relax. Get into the samiti activities. We had just formed a new samiti building in our town, and after Salem samiti is the existing one, then we had the need to have another center opened up because there are so many people around in the other part of the city. So the Salem Suramangalam samiti had come up. Can I have the slides rolling, please? Next one. So this is the auditorium where Swami used to give. And yeah, just hold on to this. Okay, this is the auditorium where Swami gave the summer course. This is my college auditorium. Yeah, next one. Yeah, so you can see this beautiful building came out of nothing. This is all miracle by Swami and full of devotees where they can fund for such a huge buildings, you know. So everything, the fund flowed by from somewhere, nowhere, 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 and we had such a nice temple built. Please go in. Let's get into the temple. Next one. Here is Swami inside the temple and inside our hearts. You know, now I started seeing Swami in my heart because there is no more physical Swami who was there during my college days present with me. Now I have to experience that love. I have to feel that love those days I had, which is now need to be experienced. And for everybody who had not seen Swami physically, his very name and very chanting of his blessed name, very chanting of his bhajans gets his heart into you, gets his love and his complete identity within you. Let's all remove all our bad feeling, kama, krodha, mada, vatsarya, everything. Then you get a bigger place for accommodation to Swami, like the big chair that you see inside your heart. And love, 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 love is all that Swami is expecting from us. And I would like to just end this whole samarpan to you all with a nice song which Swami himself asked all the students to sing. And believe me, after singing this chorus, Swami said that my hunger is appeased. Imagine the great Lord who's feeding everybody says that my hunger is appeased by this song. Let's all listen to this beautiful song on love. Sai Ram.
भगवान ब्लेसेस ऑल ऑफ यू
अंदर तेरी वो पाठ है मेरा
भगवान वांट्स ऑल स्टूडेंट्स टू सिंग टुगेदर इन कोरस
वन सॉन्ग
वन Bhagavan's appetite, hunger, is fully satiated with this melodious singing.